Welcome to our Headless Professor video on independent and dependent variables. Remember from our first unit, we talked about stimulus, organism, and response. We're going to carry our analysis a little bit deeper today. We're going to see that a stimulus is actually an independent variable, a potential cause of behavior. Organismic background factors are another important independent variable, another set of causes or influences upon behavior. We can regard each response as a dependent variable. In other words, consider it as some kind of effect influenced by both external stimuli and internal organismic background factors. Let's start with those external stimuli. One stimulus or several stimuli. What we are talking about is a change in the environment of the organism. Specifically, some kind of change in the energy level, such as more light, more sound, more vibration. Some change in the energy level that the organism can perceive. Stimuli would therefore include sights, sounds, smells, vibrations, but also interpersonal activities, even economic changes like earning more money. All of these could stimulate us to respond in different ways. Then we have some internal factors pertaining to the organism. Remember that the organism is the subject or participant of our study. In psychology, the organism could be a person or an animal that we are looking at. Each person carries around a set of background factors. For example, heredity, age, gender, and of course, all the things that happened to that particular person back in early childhood. Then we come to the dependent variable, the response, the behavior that that organism is going to engage in. The kinds of behaviors that we could look at as dependent variables in psychology would be attitudes expressed on a questionnaire, measures of performance in industrial psychology, the kind of decisions that a consumer makes in marketing research. In clinical psychology or industrial psychology, we would view the treatment or the training that is prescribed as a kind of independent variable, and the person's response to that training, in other words, the improvement, as a kind of dependent variable. If you have any questions or comments about these videos, you can reach me at brink@usa.com. If you're one of my students, you have two authorized email addresses to use when you contact me.